Hey, Martin, gotta ask you a question. Gerald Washington just told me that Ronda Rousey would kick John Pollman's ass. Do you agree or disagree?
Well,
now, be honest.
No, he was one of them, too. That's what I'm telling you.
Well, you, too.
I'm going to have to say that that John would get taken down pretty quick. He thinks that he's
not strong enough. I could like let her get a hold of me. She won't take me down.
This is where we disagree. I go back to the same thing I said. If they kept it boxing, John will take Ronda.
Okay, if it's Miesha Tate.
But,
none of those girls
Miesha Tate can though. Take me down anytime.
And you let her. She's beautiful even without makeup.
I wouldn't have to let her. She could do it anyways, but I would let her anyways.
The thing is, Holly Holm did was hit Ronda Rousey with this. She couldn't get past it. She couldn't get past it. I don't know.
Wait, so who's hotter? Oh. Miesha Tate or Ronda Rousey?
We're talking about a street fight.
I like brunettes, man. I'm gonna have to go with Miesha.
A lot of people, I think, will agree with you.
See her at weigh-ins?
Did you see that the little video with the security guard? And she's taking off her thing at the weigh-in.
Yeah. I did.
Side eye,
yeah, but you try not to look.
There was one of I forgot who it might have been. Ronda, it might have been Ronda and Miesha. I forget which one it was, but it was the weight, and they step off the scale, and they're both doing the post up thing. And Joe Rogan's back there.
So yeah,
he does this number. He's like, I know how much you love Joe. So
it's not that much. Listen, one of his most outlandish comments in the history of the world. Ronda Rousey is not an athlete of once in a lifetime. She's an athlete of once in a mankind. That's not exaggerating. With 13 fights,
and then Joe gets worked up, man. If you ever notice, like in the moment, Joe, like that's one of the things I love about him. He gets so into it. He gets so excited that in the moment, everything is the best thing ever. That's the best takedown I've ever seen. Oh my God, did you see that? You know, everything is the best ever in the moment.
He's always in PlayStation mode, huh?
Yeah, and I get the same way. I watch him like, oh, this guy's the best. You know, like he gets caught up in the moment, man. I love Joe, dude. I don't know Joe. Surprisingly, I've never met him.
So, no, but on a serious note, you really think that female MMA fighters would get John Pollman?
What's that?
Would they take him down?
These girls go to fight academy, bro. These girls don't just roll with girls. You know, I see 140 pound girls rolling with dudes Gerald's size. Are they getting handled?
That's
yeah.
If they let them. That shit only
no,
works.
They're getting
that,
handled.
That only
they're
works.
Getting handled, but they're
works.
Rolling.
It only works if you allow them to. Like if I'm really trying, there's no way. It's impossible. If I let her,
I don't know.
Put her hand
can we
on
set
me?
Up a sparring session? Can you bring in some MMA fighters?
Oh, some female. Right?
See what happens, because the only thing is I'm gonna go for real and somebody's gonna get hurt.
Okay, like no, that. We don't. He doesn't play. You don't play boxing.
It just won't make any sense.
I'm gonna bring John out to FA one night.
All right, do it.
Like, oh, everybody starts in this position. Everybody, yeah, I'm sure she'll do fine. She'll do fine like that. But if I'm dead serious, and she's gonna, there's no way.
If your life is on the line,
it's impossible. Not strong enough. You can have the perfect technique in the world, but she's just not physically strong enough to implement.
You're right. Look, we've all sparred. You've sparred someone that was three times your size. I don't care how good you are. If you spar Gerald.
I know my homie Chuck came in here. What's Chuck? 245, and I owned his ass every time. Every time. How many times you watch me choke his big ass out?
You're also a man, though.
But how many? 70 pounds is 70 pounds, bro.
Yeah,
but, you know, I'm talking about condition.
What?
Cardio.
Look, there's a reason that things are separated into
weight classes.
Weight classes and men and women.
That's way different. Weight classes.
And there's a difference in the strength between men and women. But the reason technique was invented was to trump size.
Yeah, but that
and so if your technique is perfect, then theoretically it should trump size. So if you can effectively stop a wrestler, and this is what I like about MMA is this exact conversation that we're having. If you take, this is what I liked about the Honda, I keep calling it the Ronda and Holly fight, was it was a classic MMA fight. What happens when you take a judo fighter and a kickboxer? What happens when you take a karate guy and a wrestler? So that's the name of the game. That's the whole point. So now if you take weekend. Two fights, the same way. You take an elite level stand-up fighter and an elite level wrestler, and you put them in the ring, and what happens?
The wrestler.
Same thing goes the other way, though. I've seen great stand-up guys with great... And since we're talking about the women, let's talk about the women. 115-pound division, you go on me and J-check. Great defensive wrestling, excellent stand-up. Right? So everybody comes in, tries to take her down. If you can't take down the stand-up fighter, the wrestler's going to lose. But if the stand-up fighter doesn't have any defense to takedowns...
It's like Cain Velasquez, known for his wrestling.
Right.
And he was fighting Dos Anjos, who's known for punching.
Right. Right. It goes... It's a trade-off. It's like, when I come in here and I box with these guys. Can I box with these guys? No, they whoop my ass. They own me.
Because that's all they do.
It's a different sport. So if you've got no takedown defense, and somebody comes in trying to take you down, guess what?
You're going
and
down.
And if you don't know what you do when you get down there, somebody who studies an art of that's making it. Your natural response a mistake.
You're right. Repetition.
So, I think John just wants Ronda to take it down.
Listen, all I said before, if a guy don't know anything about fighting, she'll probably beat him up, but she ain't taking me down. There's no way.
We'll have to see.
I got takedowns. John, I got everything. I've been in probably 1,000 fights in my life.
Street fights too?
Everything. I was boxing in the gym all the time. I got a bunch of amateur fights.
John was a TKD guy. He had a black belt.
I did martial arts. I did jiu-jitsu.
You did jiu-jitsu? What's your level?
I was 12 years old. No, I don't know. I was just for like a couple years. I did all that shit.
It's muscle memory. You never forget it.
No, I'm not saying I'm a jiu-jitsu practitioner, but I know enough. That she's not doing it. I ain't going for that.
That's a secret weapon. He didn't tell me he had that background. Like,
now, I seen a picture of him in a teenager with the gi on and the little taekwondo belt going.
Listen, I think it's good for every kid to do martial arts as a kid.
I think it's
age 5, 7, 9. No matter if you do basketball, football, baseball, get in a boxing gym. Get into a martial arts gym.
I think it's good for kids to do something.
Confidence, discipline.
All right. Find what makes you tweak and go for that.
There you have it. Stay tuned. FaceReport.com and Malisa Crack Reporting.